Besides barcode scanning, you also have the generation of barcodes, which can come in handy inside of your application. I already made a couple of videos on the Camera.MAUI plugin, which can not only show you camera view and take pictures, scan barcodes, but it can also generate barcodes. So let's see how to do that in this video. Use of barcodes and QR codes, which is also still a barcode, is still very popular. You can use it to scan certain products or groups of products, or you can identify, maybe you have some kind of order picking system and you want to generate your own barcode to identify a certain lot or a certain product, or you want to generate a QR code, which is still very popular. Not the most pretty thing to look at, to, I don't know, exchange URLs, contact information, connect on a social network. You can do all these kinds of things. So it's no surprise that generating barcodes is still a very popular thing to do. With the Camera.MAUI plugin, it is super, super easy. So let's just dive into the code and see how to actually do that. If you've been following my channel, then you know what's coming next. Here in Visual Studio 2022, I have created a file new .NET MAUI application just to show you how to get started with this from scratch. On the right, you can see the Android emulator already running, but this is supported on all the platforms that are supported by .NET MAUI, iOS, macOS, Windows, and Android. Android is just a vehicle to show you how to work with this. So it's running right now. You can see the file new template. I'm just gonna, well, actually, let's just stop it because else there will be kind of weirdness with the deployment right here. And the first thing you want to do is go to your Solution Explorer, right-click on your project and do Manage NuGet Packages. We're first going to install the plugin that we're going to use here. And you want to look for Camera.MAUI, which is the name of the plugin. At the time of recording, version 1.2.1 is the most current one. You might see a newer one if you're going to watch this. Install that, and it's going to bring in a bunch of dependencies. We have to accept, of course, the license agreements here for all these things. And we see a little error here. You can disregard that. This is just some mismatch between my templates and the .NET MAUI version that I'm running on, all the development bits going on here, so you shouldn't see that. But here we are. The plugin is installed, all good here. And now I actually doubt if we need to do this because in the documentation for this plugin, it said that you have to go into your MAUI program and here go to your MAUI app builder and say use MAUI camera view. But I think this is only for the camera view. So if you're not going to use that, if you didn't watch the other videos and you're not going to use that camera view, I don't think we need this. So let's try, and else we'll have to come back and still add it. But we're going to be a little bit adventurous here and we're going to try. Okay, so we got this, no things in the MAUI program. We don't need to do the permissions because we're not going to use the camera. We're just going to use the generation of barcodes. So let's go over to our main page.xaml, and I'm going to replace all of this inside of this vertical stack layout. I could also remove the vertical stack layout, I guess, because I'm not going to stack anything right now, but I'm just going to keep it for now. And what I can do is I have to import this XML namespace, so XML NS, and then I can name this, right? So let's call this still camera view CV is, and then you can look for camera view in here, and you need this one. So let's IntelliSense help you CLR namespace camera.maui in the assembly camera.maui. So we got that in place, and now we can use that CV identifier here for a couple of things. We can see the camera view. I got videos on that. Go check it out. The link's down below, or it should pop up in your screen. But we're going to focus on the barcode image for this video. So we got that one. And now there's a bunch of things you can do. The most obvious ones is you probably want to set a width and a height. So let's set a width request of, 400, and let's set a height request also of 400 so that it's nice and square. I like that. And you also can set the barcode width and height, because else, like, the width and height that you set for this is going to be the .NET MAUI control basically, and the barcode width and height will be placed inside of that. Typically, I would guess that you would have the same size, but if you make the barcode size smaller, then it might become blurred and impossible to scan. So I'm not sure it's set here in the documentation. It might be that the width and height will just become the same if you don't specify it. But there's options here, and just to be sure that my demo is going to succeed here, I'm going to set these properties just so that we are in the clear. Okay, we got that. What else do we got? Barcode. We have the background, we have the foreground, so we can specify colors for that. Let's do something funky here. I'm going to do, well, the background is just going to be white, right? Let's not get too crazy here. And the foreground is going to be blue, which is always nice. So we can see that we can have different options here. Then, of course, what's probably important is the barcode format. So you want to specify the format. And you can see all the supported formats here. So we have a very, very much bunch of those. So let's go with the QR code that is like nice and much options, and we can just put something in there. And then of course we want to actually put some value in there, right? So we want to put the barcode in there. So we're going to say, I don't know, something random like don't forget to like and subscribe. I think the and sign, the ampersand, is like not great in XAML. So let's just go with this one. So maybe you have a channel, a video that you're now watching that pops in your head that you want to like and subscribe. Please do it now. This is your sign. Thank you so much. Okay, so we have that barcode value, which can be anything, of course, right? It can be a URL, can be text in case of a QR code. It can be anything that can be scanned. So we have this, and this is basically everything that we need to do. So let's check out if this is actually going to create the barcode or we need that little initialization line. But this is how easy it is to generate barcodes. And of course, I think the barcode property is a bindable property. So you can also use this with MVVM. You can just bind to your thing, right? Here and oh, we got a couple of errors right here because yes, we removed something from the UI, but in our code behind there are still references to buttons and stuff. I'm just gonna leave this in just so you know that I make dumb mistakes as well. Here we go, just remove this, and I think now it should be much better. We should have no build errors. So I'm going to run this project and hopefully we should see that QR code come up on our emulator to actually show you that, you know, we can generate barcodes with this amazing plugin. Okay, so this fixed the build apparently, and the application is deploying right now. We can see the barcode. Well, it's a little bit of a tiny barcode. That's interesting. I might realize what I did wrong. While preparing this, I noticed that you also have this barcode margin, and I'm not really sure, like, obviously this does something with the margin. I'm not really sure if this is supposed to happen, but if you set this to something like 5, then you can see that it suddenly becomes much bigger. So, you know, you have to kind of set that or play with like the width request and height request to see how it does in your layout and how you will get the actual right size for your application. And you can see by XAML hot reload that this influences this directly, so you can play with that without stopping your application, right? So that's pretty cool as well. So I don't know, maybe make this bigger. Maybe I should not go off script. See, now I'm doing all kinds of weird things. So you probably want to play with that margin that I had in here. I'll make sure that's there for the repo as well in the link down below. And that's how you can generate barcodes with this Camera.MAUI plugin. Taking pictures, scanning barcodes, generating barcodes, is there something this plugin cannot do? I think I already did it, but this is definitely one for Gerald's Amazing Plugin Alert, right? So hereby, again, Gerald's Amazing Plugin Alert. Camera.MAUI, definitely go check it out on the repository. Make sure that you start it. If you try it and let me know how it goes in your application, please let me know in the comments, or if there's something that you can figure out and want to see a video about, I would much appreciate that. Also, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and maybe check out another video from this wonderful channel if you can't get enough of me. In this playlist, there is enough videos about .NET MAUI, and this video, my friend, is recommended just for you at this time, at this place. Maybe you'll never see it again, so click it.